Vietnam weekly news highlights. Vietnam, one of three hottest markets in Southeast Asia for 2022. Disbursed social investment capital up 8.9% in quarter one. Budget revenue from foreign trade rises over 22% in quarter one. Foreign arrivals to Vietnam surge in quarter one. Vietnam has been picked by analysts from leading Wall Street banks as one of the three hottest markets in the Southeast Asian region, according to the US TV channel CNBC. Desmond Lo, a portfolio manager at JP Morgan Asset Management, described Vietnam as a star performer in the past few years in economic resiliency and growth. Vietnam is one of the few economies globally to have seen positive economic growth throughout the pandemic, he added. The Vietnam economy is expected to rebound to 6.5% this year and further expand to 6.7% in 2023, the highest in Southeast Asia. The regional average will be 4.9% in 2022 and 5.2% in the next year, according to a report released Wednesday by the Asian Development Bank. The total amount of social investment capital disbursed in the first quarter of 2021 was estimated at 562.2 trillion dongs, $24.6 billion US dollars, up 8.9% year-on-year, reported the General Statistics Office, GSO. In particular, the disbursement of foreign direct investment, FDI, reached the highest level for quarter one in the 2018 to 2021 period, importantly contributing to the country's economic growth in 2022. In January to March, disbursement of investment capital of the state, non-state, and FDI sectors increased by 9.3%, 9.1%, and 7.9% respectively. The disbursement of capital from the central budget reached 12.2 trillion dongs, equal to 12% of the year's plan and up 17.8% year-on-year. Meanwhile, 64.1 trillion dongs from local budgets was disbursed, 9.3% higher than that of the same period last year. The state budget revenue from export and import reached 107.3 trillion dongs, nearly 4.7 billion US dollars, in the first quarter of 2022, up 22.44% year-on-year. This is equivalent to 30.5% of the year's target, according to the General Department of Vietnam Customs. Also in quarter one, the customs sector coordinated with relevant agencies to uncover 3,706 violation cases involving over 1.28 trillion dongs worth of goods, collecting over 69.9 billion dongs for the budget. The number of foreign arrivals to Vietnam in the first quarter of this year jumped 89.1% year-on-year to 91,000 as the country has fully reopened and many international flights have been restored, according to General Statistics Office, GSO. Hanoi Weekly News Highlights. Hanoi allows karaokes, bars, massage venues to reopen from April 8. Hanoi lures $513 million US dollars in foreign investment in quarter one. Hanoi GRDP growth in quarter one hits 5.83%. Hanoi housing prices keep rising on low supply. Hanoi's authorities will allow the reopening of karaokes, bars, massage venues, and gaming centers from April 8, according to the city's latest COVID-19 adaptation plan released on April 6 afternoon. These places, considered posing high risks for coronavirus spreading, are usually the first to be closed when a COVID-19 outbreak occurs and the last to reopen when it eases. They have been ordered to shut down in the capital since late April last year in response to the emergence of the fourth wave of infections in the country. The venues must ensure COVID-19 prevention and control measures as per health authority guidelines and advise customers with suspected COVID-19 symptoms, fever, coughing, breathing difficulties and loss of taste and smell, for example, to to avoid using the services and instead seek medical instructions from local health authorities. Hanoi attracted more than $513 million in foreign investment in the first quarter of this year, according to the Municipal Statistics Office. During the reviewed period, the capital city lured 62 new projects with combined investment of $24.9 million, while 28 operational projects registered to increase their capital by $122.8 million. Foreign investors contributed capital and purchased shares worth $365.4 million, the office said. The number of newly established enterprises in the capital city stood at 5,965, with a cumulative registered capital amounting to 63.5 trillion dongs, $2.78 billion, up 2% and 4%, respectively, as compared with the same period last year. The city's export revenue was posted at $3.6 billion, up 6.1%, while import revenue reached $9.1 billion, up 18.5% over the same period last year. Hanoi's gross regional domestic product, GRDP, growth in the first quarter is estimated at 5.83% year-on-year, demonstrating the recovery trend in socioeconomic development, according to the Municipal Statistics Office. Upon breaking down, the agroforestry fishery sector expanded by 3.39%, contributing 0.07 percentage points to the overall growth, the construction and industry sectors by 5.61%, or 1.05 percentage points, and the services by 6.15%, or 4.06 percentage points. The first quarter also witnessed improvements in a number of the services sector, including an 11.22% year-on-year growth in logistics, 10.31% in finance banking, 6.08% in real estate, 10.31% in science and technology, 5.88% in education and training, and 16.49% in healthcare. Housing prices in Hanoi rose the most in 5 years, driven up by limited supply and the specter of inflation. According to leading property consultancy CBRE, the average price of a new apartment increased by 13% to $1,655 per square meter. In the secondary market, it was up 9% at $1,278. In Vietnam, housing has historically been a safe haven investment during times of high inflation. In the quarter ending in March, new housing supply was 3,500 units, down 39% quarter-on-quarter and 20% from the same period last year. The decline was caused by a new wave of COVID-19. Ho Chi Minh Weekly News Highlights. Ho Chi Minh City housing prices soar by 40%. Real estate firms are record profits this year. Ho Chi Minh City takes first steps on recovery path. Ho Chi Minh City surprises with early economic recovery. Ho Chi Minh City proposes to spend $1 billion to build Ring Road No. 3. Ho Chi Minh City announces management regulation of urban architecture. Housing prices in Ho Chi Minh City and neighboring provinces increased by 42 to 46% year-on-year in the first quarter to $7,580 and $2,630 per square meter on average. In Ho Chi Minh City, they were driven up mainly by the record price tags for two new projects in Thursday Duc City, real estate consultancy Cushman Wakefield said. Prices were up 30% from the previous quarter. In neighboring provinces like Binh Duong, Dong Nai, Long An, and Ba Ria Vung Tau, they rose by 6% during the quarter. New housing supply in the city was mainly in Thursday Duc City and Districts 12 and Binh Chan. The consultancy forecast that by the end of this year, supply in the provinces would be higher than in the city, signaling a shift in investment as the neighbors build new traffic infrastructure. Major property developers like Novaland, Fat Dat and Dat Zan are set for double-digit increases in profits this year on strong demand and relentlessly rising prices. Novaland, the second biggest listed property firm, targets a near doubling of profits to 6.5 trillion dongs, $285 million, and a 140% rise in revenues to 35.97 trillion dongs. The company's projection of these all-time high figures are based on revenues it expects from the handover of houses and other properties at 22 projects in Ho Chi Minh, Dong Nai, Binh Thuan, and Ba Ria Vung Tau this year. Fat Dat, another real estate firm in the billion-dollar club, expects revenues to triple to 10.7 trillion dongs and profits to rise by 56% to 3.6 trillion dongs. Many other companies in the sector also expect profits to rise sharply this year as demand is driven up by post-COVID recovery and risk of inflation. For Vietnamese, real estate is a safe haven investment during times of inflation. As soon as the pandemic passed, real estate companies accelerated things to regain what they had lost in the last 2 years. This year will be a turning point, a test for the market. Ho Chi Minh City's economy is recovering from the impacts of COVID-19 with its tax revenues rising by 9% year-on-year and GDP again growing after shrinking for 2 quarters. The Ho Chi Minh City economy beat experts' predictions with 1.88% growth in the first quarter after shrinking by 11.6% and 25% in the last 2 quarters. We forecast its GDP to marginally decline, and the positive result was unexpected, Tran Hong Non, head of the Ho Chi Minh Institute for Development Studies, said at a meeting Tuesday. Pointing out tax revenues increased by 9.4% year-on-year and industrial growth was 1%, he said these are signs the city's economic revival programs have been effective. Echoing Non, director of the City Department of Planning and Investment, Lu Thi Win Mai, said the city is recovering faster than expected thanks to a 2.87% rally by the services sector. The services sector accounted for 96.8% of growth, while around 98% of factories have resumed operations, she added. Trade expanded by 3.5% to $11.9 billion despite the impacts of COVID-19 and the conflict between Russia and Ukraine. City Party Committee Secretary Nguyen Van Nhân expressed surprise at the performance, but warned against complacency, saying there are growing challenges. At the fifth session of Ho Chi Minh City People's Council for the 10th tenure this morning, the People's Committee of Ho Chi Minh City submitted the policy for investment and implementation of the Ho Chi Minh City's Ring Road No. 3 project, ensuring the capital balance allocated by the city budget to carry out the Ho Chi Minh City's Ring Road Belt No. 2 project to the municipal the People's Council. Additionally, the People's Committee of Ho Chi Minh City also submitted on converting the forest use purpose to another purpose in order to implement the Ring Road No. 3 project, which will be implemented under the form of public investment from the central and local budgets with the total investment capital of nearly 75,400 billion dongs, $3.3 billion, including over 24 trillion dongs, $1 billion, from the budget of Ho Chi Minh City. The Ho Chi Minh City Department of Planning and Architecture yesterday held a conference to announce the management regulation of urban architecture with the participation of leaders of districts in Thursday Duc City. At the conference, Deputy Director of the Municipal Department of Planning and Architecture Truong Trung Kien received opinions and answered the questions from participants to complete the regulation. Localities needed to comprehensively study the provisions of the regulation to well implement. Apart from the management of each area, the regulation also classified the management of the typical work for townhouses and villas, which is a foundation for granting construction permits. Local residents can easily follow the plan and architecture regulations to start work on their projects. Earlier, the Ho Chi Minh City People's Committee approved the management regulation of urban architecture.